family, it's your Serenity Rose, and we're back with another video. And as you guys can tell by the title, we are going to be doing a nighttime skin routine. So I wanted to wait to do this video until I had a full base of makeup on that I wanted to take off, so you guys can see the routine from beginning to end. Normally I have my contacts in, so I would obviously pop those out, but I don't have my contacts in today. I do have my lashes on, so first things first, I'm gonna take these lashes off. That airway lash glue is crazy strong, so you want to make sure you don't get it on a lash because it will rip it out like I just did. I'm tearing. Okay, I'm having technical difficulties, so let me take this lash off and I'll be back. Okay, so I finally got my lashes off. So next things next. Right now, normally I will go in with a oil or a cleansing balm to melt off the makeup. So I am currently using the Palmer's Cocoa Butter Ultra Gentle Facial Cleansing Oil. It says that it balances moisture and lightly hydrates. It says it removes eye makeup with 8 pure oils, and this is for all skin types. So this is the oil that I'm currently using. And as far as like a cleansing balm, I've been using the Pond's Cold Cream Makeup Remover. This is a deep cleanser. Does a really good job at removing the makeup. Right now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use my Garnier Skin Active Micellar Cleansing Water. This has vitamin C in it. I think this is new. So we're gonna use this. This basically is a makeup remover. I love their micellar water. And I'm just gonna put some on some premium oval cotton pads. You can get these at Target or on Amazon. But before I do that, I am going to put my headband on so my hair doesn't really get wet. And then I'm gonna put it in a scrunchie so it's not in my face. So I'm just gonna pour some onto the cotton pad. I really use this just to like start removing the layer of makeup. I use 2 pads, one for one side of the face and then one for the other side of the face. If you don't have this, makeup wipes works for this step as well. You may or may not hear my boyfriend in the background. He's streaming right now, so you know how that goes. Also, this is a fake tattoo, but I really do want to get a rose here, you know, for my rose fam. But I do love roses, although I've only received them once ever in my life from my boyfriend. When we first met, he got me a red rose because I don't even think I told him that I never got flowers, and he got me a rose, so that was nice. Okay, so after that step, if I feel like I still have a lot of makeup on, I will go in with either the oil or the cleansing balm, which I am going to do. I'm gonna use this. I use this like exfoliating spatula brush that I got from Cosmetics in a BoxyCharm box. So I'm just gonna pick this up and just start massaging it into the face. Then I'm gonna get the water running so that by the time I'm done pushing this into my face, the water's nice and warm. I do use cold water at the very end when I'm rinsing everything off and I'm done applying stuff to my face as far as cleansing goes, but I like to use warm water throughout my cleansing process. As you can see, there's still a lot of makeup on my face. I And I'm just gonna use my hands to go rubbing this in. I'm gonna get it over my eyes, and then I'm gonna go and rinse it off, and we'll move on to the next step. So I'm gonna take a towel and start wiping that down. Okay, so let's move on to the next step. So now that that's done, I'm going to cleanse my face slash exfoliate. So I'm gonna use the Murad Hydration AHA BHA Exfoliating Cleanser. This does have little like micro beads in there that really do a nice job at exfoliating. It is not harsh at all, so I do like that. I did receive this in a BoxyCharm, but I'm pretty sure you can find this if you look it up online, or maybe even at Marshall's or TJ Maxx. So we're gonna put a little bit in, massage it into the face, and then rinse it off. And I am gonna have the water cold because this is the last cleansing step. I take about that much, massage it into my fingers, and then work it into the face. And I try to avoid my eyes with this stuff because there's like little balls and you don't want that to go in your eyes. Next, I'm going to grab two Q-tips and I'm going to go back in with that micellar water. So I know that mascara and eyeliner is the most hardest part about cleansing, at least in my routine. So I will just put some micellar water onto the Q-tip and go like this just to get any excess mascara out. And trust me, there's always mascara left. Or if not, it's the eyeliner, as you can see. So I'm gonna take one more cotton pad with some more micellar water and do my eyes only. And this is just to make sure I get all of that makeup out. So I hold it there for a few seconds and then swipe away. And as you can see, not as much stuff is coming out. So next I'm going to brush my teeth and exfoliate my lips. I make my own sugar lip scrub, so that is what I'm going to be using. And for toothpaste, I use the Colgate Triple Action toothpaste because there's three different colors in it and it is really minty in the mouth. So I like to put a lot of toothpaste on my toothbrush, and then when I'm done washing my teeth, I will exfoliate. So next I'm going to take my pink lemon lip scrub and exfoliate my lips. And once I'm done rubbing that into my lips, I know I look crazy right now. I do that for about 30 seconds to 2 minutes, depending on if my kids are crying. If I have the time to do it longer, then I will wipe it off. Okay, so now that my lips are exfoliated, I will go in with a lip mask or a lip oil, but I do prefer lip sleeping mask overnight. So right now I'm using the Mamande Lip Sleeping Mask and Plum Blossom. And this stuff is so good. I wake up with some super smooth lips. You can use this as a lip balm or a lip sleeping mask, and I prefer to use it as a lip sleeping mask. Okay, so back to the face. So next I will go in with an astringent. Right now I'm using the Neutrogena Clear Pore Oil Eliminating Astringent. As you can see, I'm almost done, but if you're not, I have my favorite astringent already in use. I usually have one in my room, one in my bathroom, because you know, I, you know, do my face in preparation in my room at my vanity sometimes, or sometimes in my bathroom. So I'm gonna use the rest of this up. You will see this in upcoming empties, and if I run out of this, I'll just use the rest of this. And again, I take that on a cotton pad. I like to load them up so that my entire face gets it. And you want to avoid your eyes when you use this because it will burn. You can even bring this down to your neck, but I do want to note that even though you double cleanse, there's still dirt on your face. So doing all these extra steps really, really help get in there. So I let that soak in. I love astringent. It's just so nice on the skin and so refreshing. Okay, so while that's soaking in, I'm gonna go in with my eye cream. While the astringent is soaking into my skin, I'm gonna use my eye cream. So I use the Murad Hydration Hydrodynamic Ultimate Moisture for Eyes, and it looks like this. So when it comes to eye cream, you really don't need that much. So literally just take the smallest amount, like even that's too much. Just dot some right here, and then you wanna tap it in. You could rub it in if you want, but I prefer to press it into the skin. Be very, very careful not to get your eye cream into your eyes because it will burn. This eye cream thing is a new step. I used to not do this. And again, I didn't have an actual eye cream to do this with, but since I received them in my BoxyCharm, you best to believe I'm gonna be using it. That is why I love BoxyCharm. You receive things that you normally wouldn't purchase yourself. So yeah, why freaking not? I love using things what they are intended for. Like lip oils or lip mask, you know, instead of just using chapstick for everything, or lip gloss. Like, lip gloss is intended to make your lips shine, while lip oil is to hydrate your lips. Or a lip mask is meant to intensively repair them. So, next and last is my sleeping mask. So, if I'm not doing a sheet mask, I'm going to use a sleeping mask. So, right now, I am using the Dr. Brandt Hydrobiotic Recovery Sleeping Mask, and I've had this for a while, so it's really, if really depends on how you feel about using skincare, if it's expired or not. I don't mind because I keep my stuff really, you know, good and secure and closed and sealed. So I take about this much, massage it into my fingers, and then massage it into my face all over. I try to avoid the eye area because I just applied eye cream there. This stuff is so nice. And that is it for my skincare routine. Okay, so that is my nighttime skincare routine. As you can see, my skin looks nice and hydrated, which is what you want, especially if you have dry skin. But I have combo skin, so anything really works for me. But yeah, this is what it looks like with my living room light. And yeah, so my daughter's getting a bit antsy, so I'm gonna go feed her. Yeah, so I'm gonna go feed my daughter right now, but This is my updated skincare routine. This is especially for that one member of the Rose family who asked for it. So there it is. If you enjoyed watching this video, drop a thumbs up, comment down below what you guys think, and please don't forget to hit that subscribe button before you go. I would love to have you guys join the Rose family, and I hope you guys are staying safe, staying blessed, and I'm gonna catch you guys in the next video. Bye!
Can you play that again?